Titanic launched on May 31st, 1911, and set sail on its maiden voyage from Southampton on April the 10th, 1912, with 2,240 passengers and crew on board. On April the 15th, 1912, after striking an iceberg, Titanic broke apart and sank to the bottom of the ocean, taking with it the lives of more than 1,500 passengers and crew. The Titanic wreckage remains on the seabed, but since its discovery in 1985, thousands of artifacts have been recovered and put on display in museums around the world. Let's hop aboard the Titanic and take a look at some of these artifacts, as well as film-used items from the movie Titanic that are also on display here. And here we have a purse counter. And here we have a first class corridor door. And here we have the grand staircase reproduction with the cherub used from the movie Titanic. Here we also have some more original pieces. And this is the clock used in the movie Titanic. And here's some more original pieces. Looks like wall covering of some sort. And here we have a dining room door. And here we have an original piece. This would have been one of the first class lounge windows that would have been pulled from the Titanic wreckage. Here we have some original tile pulled from the wreckage site. The Titanic would have had many fine dining halls, and this is some original pieces And here is some dishware that would have been found on the Titanic during the voyage. And this would have been a caryatid, I believe is the correct pronunciation, but this would have been in place of your traditional columns in the dining rooms on the Titanic. And here we have a maid's apron and some original pieces here, as well as the jacket that you see here. And this what is the steward's jacket. And we also have a deck of playing cards and some other items. Here we have a Marconi room gimbal lamp. And this is a representation of the grand staircase carving. And here we have a column. And here we have more dishware and other items used on the Titanic. These are original pieces here in this cabinet. This would have been the second class cabin door. And this is a look at how the facilities would have looked on board the Titanic. And this would have been the control room for the Titanic. And I must say, it's a very nice view. And here we have a very huge model of the great ship called the Titanic. Here we have an original Titanic launch ticket, as well as other original items here. And now we head to the, what they called the smoking room, which would have been the lowest level, also called the boiler room. And this would have been the area on the lowest level where the guys manned the areas and kept the coal shoveled in those areas you see there to keep the engine roaring. Says here 1,535 people died during the sinking of the Titanic. And as the Titanic began to sink, it began filling up with water. And here is a representation of what it may have looked like on the ship at that time. Possibly trapped behind these iron gates. Now we watch the last moments before the sinking of the Titanic. The Titanic would have been equipped with the most latest state-of-the-art equipment, including the telegraph, which would have been commonly used back in those days to communicate with other ships. Here we have an original deck chair that was brought up from the wreckage site. This is an original deck chair that would have been used on the Titanic. One very famous passenger by the name of Wallace Henry Hartley, which was an English violinist and bandleader who played on the Titanic's maiden voyage in 1912, was found days later with his violin still strapped to his back in its case. It appears that the case protected the violin from the cold and wet conditions, and experts confirmed in 2006 that it was the actual violin that Hartley used on the Titanic. The violin can be seen on display at various locations around the world. I did get an opportunity to see it at the Titanic Museum in Pigeon Forge, Tennessee. The Carpathia eventually showed up to the site of the Titanic wreckage and was able to recover the passengers that were able to get on lifeboats, and some who survived even the very cold conditions in the water. Many movies and books have come out about the Titanic, and here are some screen-used items that were used in the most recent film, The Titanic. Here we've got Jack's original shirt there. We've got the Heart of the Ocean and a White Star Line sweater that was used. And here's some other items that Rose, the fictional character in the Titanic, would have used. And here we have some life jackets. And I do believe these life jackets were used in the movie Titanic back in 1997. And we do have the life jacket that the character Rose did wear in the movie. And here is that life jacket. After many years, the wreckage site was discovered, and here is a diagram of the wreckage site here.